Guys, it's a sad day, but it's also a happy day. But the main thing to take away from this video is the 27-inch iMac is now officially
dead.
And to be deadly honest, that does make me a bit upset. But at the same time as well, Apple have brought out something brand new and it looks absolutely amazing. We've got the brand new Mac Studio, what has just been announced, and it looks absolutely fantastic. It is basically like 2.5 Mac Minis stacked on each other, the form factor of this, but inside it, you can choose an M1 Max chipset, just like we got in the 16 and 14 inch MacBook Pros, but we also have that brand new M1 Ultra chipset, what is also absolutely incredible. What's basically two M1 Maxes sewn together to give you 20 cores and up to 64 cores GPU. And that is just absolutely bonkers in performance. We've already seen some of the benchmarks out there of what it can do. And as you can see here, it even beats the most powerful Mac Pro out there, the really, really expensive one. Now, this Mac Studio may look amazing, and you do have to buy yourself an additional screen to go with it. And in fact, you can buy the new kind of studio monitor that Apple are providing, and it looks absolutely incredible. But when you kind of add everything together, you're going to have to pay around about $2,000 at least for the Mac Studio, and you're going to have to also pay at least $1,600 for a monitor as well. So to combine, that is $3,600, which is quite a lot of money. But if you even want the M1 Ultra chip inside it, the starting price on that one, that starts at $4,000, and that without the monitor at all. So, you know, that is quite a lot of money. Do the maths, that's $5,600. Now, what the Mac Studio is replacing is the 27-inch iMac. It does seem like that Apple have completely axed away the 27-inch iMac, and it looks like it probably won't be ever returning again. If you look at Apple's website from a couple of days ago, you had the 27-inch iMac and you could get it, you could see it, you could buy it, and it had the Intel chipsets inside it that were updated in summer 2020. But today, if I go on Apple's website, the 27-inch iMac is nowhere to be seen as a new product. The only place you can see it is in the refurbished area of the Apple website. The 27-inch iMac is officially gone.
And it is dead.
And to be honest, that does sadden me. We've had the 27-inch iMac, or may I say the larger iMac, for a good couple of years now. And when I say a good couple of years, I mean almost two decades. We got it introduced in the early 2000s when Apple started introducing two different sizes of iMacs. And that's continued on all the way up to present day, where, for example, very, very recently, we used to have a 21.5-inch iMac, and then we also used to have a 27-inch iMac. And it's been like that for around the last kind of 10 years. Last year, we did get the 24-inch iMac with the M1 chipset inside it. But this year, almost a year later, what we have now is the Mac Studio, what is replacing the 27-inch iMac. Now, the 27-inch iMac is going to have a special place in my heart. I actually bought my first actual Mac, and that was actually an iMac, and it was the larger type at the time. They had a 15-inch and they had a 17-inch iMac, and I bought myself a 17-inch iMac when it came out. And since then, I've had many iMacs since. I've had a 24-inch iMac. I've also had the likes of a 27-inch iMac as well. But now, mainly, I do use MacBooks and connect them up to docks with a monitor. But I do have a Mac Mini as well. But the Mac Studio is going to be probably replacing what I'm going to have with my Mac Mini, because, you know, I am a creator on here, so it makes sense to actually have the Mac Studio, and I'm sure it's going to be great to work with that on a desk. So really looking forward to that coming in the post very soon, and I actually am going to be making some videos about the new Mac Studio. So if you are new here, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell. But moving on, the actual iMac itself. It's really sad, like I said, that it has disappeared, especially that you could pick up a 27-inch iMac just only a couple of days ago for $1,800, and this gave you everything inside it. You got your chipset, you got your screen, you got your keyboard, you got your mouse. And now, fast forward a couple of days later, when we've got the new Mac Studio, you have to buy the Mac Studio, you have to buy yourself a separate monitor, you have to buy yourself a keyboard, you have to buy yourself a mouse if you wanted to, or you've got to bring your own ones along. But yeah, it costs like over double, or even three times, or even four times the amount of what you could get with a 27-inch iMac. And to be honest, I am quite disappointed that Apple have stopped doing that. But the one thing that I won't stop doing is giveaways on this channel, just like I'm doing right now for this iPhone 13 Pro Max in this silver white color that you can see here. There's a 256 gigabyte model. And I'm gonna be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 350,000 subscribers. And it's not that far away. And all I want to know from you guys, are you planning to buy any of the Apple tech that was announced a few days ago? Or are you planning to buy any Apple tech in 2022 or any technology in 2022? Write it down in the comments below because I'd love to know, and it will enter you into the giveaway of this iPhone. Also at the same time as well, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also hit that notification bell because I'll be announcing who the lucky subscriber is for this iPhone 13 Pro Max when we get over 350,000 subscribers. Now I have said this before, there are lots of scammers and spammers out there. Lots of them impersonating myself, telling you to WhatsApp them, Telegram you now even. This is not me at all, and I will not be doing this at all, and I will not be sending you any messages to tell you that you've won a prize. Like I said, I'll be doing it via video when we get over 350,000 subscribers. So if you see these people, report them, or delete them, or ignore them completely. With that out of the way, let's talk a little bit more about the 27-inch iMac. Now, something what confuses everything is that we've been actually expecting a larger iMac for some time now with kind of an M1 chipset variant inside it. Obviously, we were hoping it would probably get an M1 Max inside it or M1 Pro, but now ever since we had the announcement of the M1 Ultra, we've been hopeful for a 27-inch iMac with an M1 Ultra. And this doesn't seem it's going to be the case anymore. It doesn't look like this is ever going to come out. There has been lots of leaks and rumors over the years saying that we are going to get it, and in fact, quite recently, Ming-Chi Kuo actually also left a leak here where he even said that the brand new 27-inch iMac and also the Mac Pro is coming in 2023. And personally, I don't think this is going to be true now, especially Apple actually said this.
Making our transition nearly complete with just one more product to go, Mac Pro. But that is for another day.
And why would they say that if it's going to come out in 2023? It doesn't make sense. And remember, Tim Cook also said there was going to be a 2-year transition to move all the Mac line into Apple Silicon within 2 years. That journey started at the end of November sort of time in 2020, and we're coming up to summer 2022. So it makes sense for the new Mac Pro to be announced at the actual Apple event in the summer at WWDC, like the Mac Pros have done in the past. In 2019, we saw it announced at WWDC. In 2013, we saw another Mac Pro announced. It just makes sense for it to come out and be announced in the summer this year. But what most likely we will also see is possibly the next generations of chipsets. Because remember, Apple also said this.
We're adding one last chip to the M1 family. Introducing M1 Ultra.
So it seems quite likely that the Mac Pro will not be getting anything with an M1 variant chipset inside it, not even the M1 Ultra. Or it might get the M1 Ultra as its kind of baseline configuration, the cheapest one out there, but it seems like that they're not going to be making any more kind of M1 variants for the time being, and it looks like we're going to be stepping into M2 territory, the next generation, and the Mac Pro might be the first device to actually get the new M2 kind of chips inside it. So it's quite exciting. But back to the 27-inch iMac. Yeah, officially, it is dead from the sounds of it. Unless Ming-Chi Kuo is correct, in 2023, we do see a new one. But personally, from my point of view, I don't think there is. But what I would like to say is this. The 27-inch iMac has been a fantastic model for many, many years. And I know a lot of you people out there, even probably watching this video, are watching it on a 27-inch iMac. And it is sad to see it go. And I'd love to know, you guys, if you've ever had a 27-inch iMac or a larger iMac, what your experiences have been with it, and will you be sad to see it go? Put it down in the comments below. And also at the same time as well, what I'm also going to say is I might even make a tribute video and a bit of a history for the 27-inch iMac in the future, because to me it's been such an amazing device and I think it deserves a good farewell. Well, with that out of the way, guys, what I will say is it's time to wrap up the video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time as well, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please also make sure you hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye.